we are going to study pollination. Pollination, it is the process or it is the act in which pollen grains, these are the pollen grains, which are transferred from anther to the stigma. In previous lecture, you had studied about the structure of androecium, androecium or stamen, which consists of anther and filament, while gynoecium or pistil, it consists of stigma, style and ovary. So in pollination, pollen grains which are transferred from anther to the stigma, it is a process or it is the act in which pollen grains or microspores which are transferred from anther to the stigma. Now see, why this process is necessary or why it is essential? It is essential for the process of fertilization. What is fertilization? Fertilization is the process in which male gametes, which are produced inside the pollen grain, they are transferred, and these male gametes are carried towards the egg, which is produced inside the ovule. Inside the ovule, egg is produced. So it fuses with egg and it leads to the process of fertilization. After fertilization, fruit is produced. Inside the fruit, seeds are produced. Inside the seed, or these seeds produces the new plants. So it is the essential or it is required for the process of fertilization. Pollination is essential for the process of fertilization. Now see, why angiosperm? It is the most evolved group. Angiosperm is most evolved because it shows the following strategies. First is use of abiotic and biotic agents to their flower. Biotic and abiotic. Abiotic means wind, water, etc. While biotic, like insects, birds, bat, etc. These are the biotic agents. So first strategy, why angiosperms, they are evolved group. You know the meaning of angiosperm. Angion means inside and sperm means seeds. Seeds are produced inside the fruit. So these seeds, they are produced inside the fruit. That's why we call these plants as angiosperms. So first strategy you had studied, use of biotic and abiotic agents to their flowers. Now see the next, flowers help to feed the visitors by producing honey, nectar and edible pollen grains. So how these visitors, they feed? Visitor means agents, or they are also called as pollinators. Flowers helps to feed these visitors. How they are used to feed? By producing, what they produce? Honey. You know honey. Nectar. Nectar is also the sweet substance produced by flower. And edible pollen grains means birds, insects, they can eat the pollen grain. That's why we call them edible pollen grain. In this way, these visitors or these agents, they are feeded by these flowers. Now see the next, flowers exploit means flowers use the mobility of these agents for pollination. How they use the mobility for pollination? As these male gametes which are produced inside the pollen tube, they are non-motile. As they are non-motile, they are carried with the help of these agents. These are the agents towards the stigma. And this mobility is exploited by the flowers. Next strategy, pollinators also helps in seed dispersal. Seed dispersal means seeds can be transferred from one place to another with the help of these pollinators. Now see, there are three types of pollination on the basis of sources. First is self-pollination, or it is also termed as autogamy. Auto means self. When pollen grains are transferred from anther to the stigma of same flower, when flower is same plant, same flower, we use the term self-pollination or we use the term autogamy. Here, inbreeding or self-pollinating pollination takes place. And another type is cross-pollination. Cross-pollination is also called as allogamy. It is also called as allo. Allo means cross. Auto means self. So when self-pollination takes place, we use the term autogamy. In autogamy, transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma of same flower takes place. Example of autogamy is pea. While in cross-pollination, here pollen grains are carried from flowers of one anther to the stigma of another flower. It is called as cross-pollination.